Happy morning, dear students. I am very happy to meet you all again through this video. I hope you all are staying safe and healthy at home. Today, in this video, we will recall the concepts that we learnt in the previous virtual classes. Let's begin. We learnt about matter. What is matter? Anything around us which has mass and occupies space is called matter. What is mass? The amount of particle present in an object. Very good. Matter is made up of atoms and molecules. Okay. Atom is a smallest unit or basic building block of all matter. Okay. Then an atom is composed of 3 subatomic particles. They are proton, neutron and electron. Proton, which are positively charged, electron negatively charged, and neutron have no charge. Very good. Next, molecule. 2 or more atoms combine to form molecule. A molecule can either be made up of a same type of atoms, like molecules of oxygen, O2, or different type of atoms like water molecule. Next, we learnt about the 4 characteristics of molecules. They are, molecules are very small in size, molecules have space between them, molecules are constantly moving, and molecules attract each other. The space between the molecules are known as intermolecular space, and the force of attraction between the molecules are known as intermolecular force of attraction. There are 2 types of intermolecular force. They are force of cohesion and force of adhesion. The force of attraction that exists between the same type of molecules is called the force of cohesion or cohesive force. The force of attraction that exists between the different types of molecules is called the force of adhesion or adhesive force. Here if you see, these are molecules of water, H2O. Okay. So what type of intermolecular force is present between these molecules? Yes, cohesive force. Because these molecules are of same type. The force exists between the same type of molecule is cohesive force. Now in this case, what will be the force between the water molecule and this glass test tube? Correct. The force between the molecules of water and molecules of this glass test tube will be adhesive force. Why? Because molecules of water is different from molecules of this glass tube. We already knew that the force of attraction exists between different types of molecule is called adhesive force. Next, we will learn about 3 states of matter. Based on the arrangement of molecules, matter exists in 3 states. They are solid state, liquid state and gas state. In solids, the molecules are closely packed. In liquids, molecules are not very closely packed. And in gas state, molecules are very loosely packed. Let's learn the characteristics of solid, liquid and gas. Solid. The state of matter in which constituent molecules are closely packed is known as solid. Intermolecular distance between the molecules of solid is very less. Why? Because the molecules are very closely packed. Since they are very closely packed, intermolecular distance will be very less in solids. And what about the intermolecular force? Intermolecular force is very strong because the molecules are very closely packed. So the intermolecular force is very strong. Next, solids expand very little on heating. Liquid. Liquid is that state of matter in which the constituent molecules are not very closely packed. So, the intermolecular distance between the molecules of liquid will be more than the solids. And what about the intermolecular force? Intermolecular force will be very weaker in liquid. Why? Because intermolecular distance is more. When the distance increases, intermolecular force decreases. Got it, children? Next, heating causes expansion in liquid. Since the molecules of liquid are loosely packed, on heating, they can expand easily. As we all know, the molecules in gases are very loosely packed. So, what will be the intermolecular distance between the molecules of gas? Yes, it will be large. And what about the intermolecular force? It is almost negligible. Negligible means we can neglect it. Okay. Why we can neglect the intermolecular force of gas? Because the molecules in gas are very far. So the force will be very less, almost negligible. Since the molecules are loosely packed, on heating, gases can expand easily. Okay, we will be learning about a few more characteristics of solid, liquid and gas in next video. With this, we come to an end of this session. I will be sending you a Google Form link after this video. Kindly do it without fail. Can these three states of matter be interchangeable? If yes, how and why? Keep guessing. Meet you all in the next class. Thank you, students.